Hi, my name is Kristopher Knowles. I am 13 years old and I live in Sarnia. I've been suffering with liver disease for all my life. I've been waiting for a liver transplant for most of my life. I have a wish. My wish is to walk across Canada to help 4,000 Canadians who need an organ transplant. My year-long walk starts January 8th in Sarnia. Become an organ donor and share this with your family. Please help my wish come true.
Support Kristopher's Wish by donating to Step by Step. Phone 416-540-7872 or 1-800-992-3645.
Arrive on the planet and blinking step into the sun. There's more to be seen than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done. Some say eat or be eaten, some say live and let live. But all I agree is to join the stampede. You should never take more than you give. In the circle of life, it's the wheel of fortune. It's the leap by faith.
turn.
Educational for me too, because I feel like I'm almost like a dad, because I'm absorbing so many people's views and opinions, and you know, and I feel like I'm a walking dad at times. And I'm able to come to a few generalizations, and they're you know, very factual generalizations after talking to thousands of people. About that we all share a similar view on how we can make things better here in this country. And that's definitely with the National Registry and with you know, more education and awareness done in every community right across Canada.
Okay, so just if I can go back and just ask that. You started last month.
In Toronto,
okay.
June 28th.
And you're going to end up December 2001?
Yes, back in Toronto. And I'll tell you how that's getting done. We're actually going to be in Ontario for the next 5.5 months because we're going through 214 communities in Ontario. And our final leg in Ontario will be around Kenora, where we'll be headed west through the prairies and towards Vancouver. And at Vancouver, we're going to hopefully have a Hercules waiting for us. And they're going to take us around the world and drop us off at St. John's, Newfoundland. And then we're going to finish the rest of the walk back from St. John's to Toronto. So it's going to have like a global effect.
Okay, are you going to be touching down in any of the other countries?
Well, yeah, I'm going to get together with the armed forces representative and see if there's any, because we have a 3-day span from Vancouver to St. John's. So, you know, this is a global issue. You know, it's about humanity and about the spirit of giving and how we can pass life on, and you know, it should touch every country in the world. So I think what we're doing here might touch the other countries.
I have a question for you. Are you afraid of heights?
Am I afraid of heights? Sometimes. Like,
just wondering how you're gonna handle in the Hercules.
Oh, because it's gonna go pretty high. I'm not gonna look down. I guess that's the idea.
Okay. And so are you gonna continue walking through the winter? Is that the plan?
Yeah, there's no days off.
Okay.
The nights.
Just the nights, yeah.
George, I gotta go. Sorry.
Okay, yeah. Once again, Mayor, our communities. And so that's 491 press conferences we got scheduled during this 500-day walk.
Welcome,
and while we're approaching the press conference,
is there anything you want to say? Well, I've got a bunch of press releases.
Yeah, this, you know, reason of inspiration for us did come from Terry Fox. Like, it really did. I have been motivated by a lot of things, or to keep on being motivated. But Daryl certainly has played a big part. And you know, like to have him say that I can call myself the Italian Terry Fox is just a great honor for me. So if you wanted to put in the headline, the Italian Terry Fox coming through Sarnia.
Okay. Alright, well, the last thing I want to
ask. I'm 44.
Okay. And where are you from?
I'm born and raised in Toronto. And if you can also mention that, you know, all this awareness and education and this whole thing isn't without expenses. We have a tremendous financial challenge over here. We need to raise about $300,000. We're trying to, right now, concentrate on securing our motorhome. We need to raise about $20,000 to do that by the end of the month.
Okay, and that $300,000 is for the
gas. Yeah. I need to at times hire drivers on the road. By the end of the day, the expenses are going up. We have a budget, a working budget. And also, as we're going from community to community, we're passing resolutions. So we need people to follow up on all these communities. And by the end of it, you can add this because this is very important. We're hoping and we're very optimistic that we're going to get 491 municipalities to pass these resolutions.
Okay.
And that's going to be a very powerful statement to the whole country that at a municipality level, that they really care, that they're doing something, and that we're going to have ongoing education and awareness programs in each one of these communities. And you know, that is something that is very...
You coach the national team.
Were you in the way?
Nope.
Oh, that wasn't going to tie in.
I saw that earlier.
Yeah, I will.
So, you know, I mean, you've seen the reaction here, and it's similar in all the other communities that we go to. Everybody wants a national registry.
Most
definitely. There's only a few people that are really preventing it from happening.
Do you want your poster signed?
Okay. I really appreciate your time.
back court, red back.
Where's the focus on your thumb?
Yeah, the focus is here. Yeah. Go get the band and follow.
We can't reach the inspiration of the Pope But we're getting all of it here from this municipality, because this is a very a community, a city that is very health conscious, and you know that we have some of the best hospitals, one of the best hospitals right here, and we do organ transplants too. And it's people like you who have survived this, and there's a young lady that I met day before yesterday who got a liver transplant at the age of 4. She's now 15, the Ross family from somewhere in Alberta. And Timmy, who wanted to know, Chris, who wanted to know that this time will come very, very soon. And he's got a long life to live, because this is the type of thing. We've got to encourage the people out there to donate the organs. But it's not just a matter of donating it. Tell people that they've done so for two reasons. To encourage others, number one, as well as to let people know so that when they die, they know that that organ is available. I was talking to some people out there and they said that, well, it's one thing to donate it, but when you die, some people don't even know that you have a heart.
Right.
So, with that said, all the very best to you.
Thank
and
you.
I want to make this presentation to you. It's a soup cup. During your travels, you can drink your soup out of it. And here's a cap to remind you that you passed through this great city of London. And attached to this cup is a penny to remind you that this is London. And on behalf of our mayor and our city council, thank you.
I also want to thank you for coming here in short notice. I know on 2 days, your schedule is probably full.
It generally is. It is. I just have to push a few things. But for this cause, I wanted to be here. First of all, I wanted to make sure that somebody was here and nobody else did come, then I decided that I would do it.
Thank you. And please do
it. I certainly will.
I want to tell, because this documentary is going to be seen by a lot of people, even outside your opinions, your feelings.
I want to start off by saying what George is doing is a good thing, and nothing harmful can come from awareness. And if anybody out there has a son like I have here, my son Kristopher, would you want to be the one to tell Kristopher that he couldn't survive because organs are not available for him to continue on in his life? I want to make it clear that it should be stated that everybody should sign or become part of a organ donation group to make it aware that you can donate your organs so people like Kristopher can continue on in life. It's not just bad people that need organ transplants. There's a lot of good people that need organ transplants. And there's a lot of good kids that need to continue on with life and can continue on with life with an organ transplant. So, basically, that's what I want to say. Sign your organ donor cards. Make it real. Make somebody, tell somebody that you want to do it. Make your wishes known. And don't be regretful later when it's too late that you could have done something to help someone and you choose not to because you were scared or unsure at the time. I know a few people that have had organ transplants and they turned out to be better people than they were before, if that's possible, because of the transplant. So whoever donates their organs, pieces of them, the one living, and it helps. It helps a kid like this.
Thank you.
like to say. We love our son. We want him to live. We want, we hope. We don't hope somebody dies so my son can live, but in that unfortunate incident, if that person did die, and they're not going to be using their organs anymore, if they could please give it to my son so my son can continue on, basically. The main message, please don't take your organs to heaven. Heaven knows we need them here. And the other one, organ and tissue donation, is a genuine act of love throughout the world. So. Yeah.
End of George's 769-day walk, which is the last one. He walked 2 years through two Canadian winters and has the tenacity, I don't think anybody ever, and a forever. Like me, he's a liver transplant recipient. George's was 2 years ago, mine was 7 weeks ago. So I hope to complete the walk. But what I'd like to do right now is pass the torch over to Betty DeFerio from City Hall here, and she might want to say a few words.
Pleased to be here on behalf of our mayor, Mel Lastman, and my colleagues on City Council to welcome George at the end of his walk across this country, around the world. Toronto is, and to welcome you to Nathan Phillips Square. Toronto is really blessed by a lot of good things. We have good neighborhoods, we have a lot of good physical architecture, but primarily we are blessed with the citizens. And George is certainly an example of that. Congratulations, George, on a job well done traveling across this country. And what surprised me to hear was that, in fact, out of all the world, we are still one of the civilized world, we're still one of the lowest in terms of donations. And I believe that George, through his teaching to other Canadians, that we will get better in bringing life to each other. We hope that everyone across this country will seriously consider donation of organs to people, to bring life to people. So George, congratulations, 769 days, unbelievable. And on your last 10K, good luck, and good luck to all of you, and thank you so much for being a citizen of this city.
When I was a constable in Toronto, he was my sergeant. And now he's really out right now.
On behalf of our Chief of Police, Julian Fantino, and over 7,000 members of the Toronto Police Service, I'd simply like to say to the people of Toronto, please continue your fine heritage of supporting each other, helping friends in need, become informed, become committed, become an organ donor. It is about life, and all we can do is be thankful for those that have made a sacrifice and a gesture to be organ donors. I know where my card is, it's with me at all times. We advocate and ask all of you to raise the torch on this adventure, on this last 10K, and on a gift of life. Thank you for coming out with me.
My particular liver transplant was a donation from my son, standing behind me. So what I'd like to do is pass the torch to Stuart, my hero, and George will pass it. Stuart will pass it to George.
That we're off to a late start, but we're going to get the show done today. I want to thank Councillor Betty DiZero for representing the City of Toronto. She's actually my councillor. She's from my area. What's it properly called now? Davenport. And, you know, St. Clair and Dufferin is the best community in Toronto. And I also want to thank retired detective Alistair Stark, who I met recently, and he's just so full of life. Like he's been inspiring me like crazy, and his son, who is also my hero. Anybody that thinks about becoming an organ donor is a hero. And also want to thank Acting Deputy Chief for coming out here also, representing the police service. And without further ado, I want to introduce Mr. John Totten, who was one of the founders of Step by Step, and he has played a big role in the campaign, and he's going to say a few words. Thank you, and we'll start walking pretty soon.
Thank you, George. Well, congratulations. 769 days is an incredible amount of time, particularly when you're struggling through snow drifts in the prairies and having your face frozen to the point where George could hardly talk. It really is an incredible feat. When George and I got together, gosh, 2 years ago, not very long after I had my liver transplant, because I too am a liver transplant patient. My disease was PSC disease, a disease that nobody knows really very much about. It's an autoimmune disease. Any one of us, anywhere in the world, can get it at any time. The only treatment for it is a liver transplant, and I was fortunate enough to get one. George and I met through a kind of a strange story I won't go into today, but it allowed us to sit down and talk about the incredible gift that we had received, the gift of life, truly the gift of life. I had spent 10 and a half months preparing to die. And I had come to the point where I had accepted that I was about to die when my organ donation arrived. It's an experience I can't describe for you. It's an experience that causes me today, nearly 5 years later, to still wake up in the morning and open my eyes and look around and say, holy smokes, I'm still here. This is truly incredible. And George and I talked about what could we do to bring everybody's attention to the urgent need for organ donation, to try and develop stronger support here in Canada. And thank goodness George decided, after we talked about the best approach would be to walk across Canada, George decided that he would do the walking. I don't think I could have made it. In any event, he has not only done the walking, the first time he walked around the province of Ontario and generated tremendous interest. He then decided he was going to go for the Canadian walk 769 days later, an almost insurmountable.
The volunteers are the spirit of this whole thing. We've got thousands of volunteers across the country. Every time I was approaching a community, there was always people ready to help me set things up and help out with funds, help out with accommodations, with food. And there's just thousands and thousands of people that I need to thank, and that kept me going. And I think that's why I'm so confident that we're going to get precious consent created, because when you go through 500 communities and all these communities are supporting you to get this created, your feelings become more confident that you're in the right direction. So after this walk today, we're going to continue pursuing to get this system created so that we can save thousands of lives. Yes. 7 years ago, I was rushed to a hospital with liver failure, and I was told I only had 2 days left to live. I was on the waiting list for a year, and just like many people that are on the waiting list, your organ's going to fail out on you sooner or later. And my funeral was already planned and everything, and I don't know. I'm just so fortunate that an organ became available the next day, and my life was saved that day. So were five others. And you know, after waking up after the operation, I felt immediately healthy. And what we wanted to do was to what I wanted to do was to acknowledge this great gift, and to let everybody know what a great gift this was. And hopefully we can give hope to those 4,000 people on the waiting list and future generations.
Thank you so much. Oh, and how do you pronounce your last name?
It's Marcello.
Sorry about that. Thanks so much.
Thank you. The torch is in the car.
Yeah, it's in the truck.
It's in, okay, we need to get it lit. We got to get started on the press conference.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Is your mom here? Or, yeah, that's right, too. Al's got a car here.
Catherine will go get the torch.
Oh.
Oh shoot. Oh hi. Oh hi.
How are you?
Not bad. Not bad.
Hi Gaetano. How are you?
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Congratulations.
Thanks. Thank you.
A lot to be proud of.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is great.
Okay.
Oh God.
We're the Knowles family. I'm Kelly. This is my wife, Sandy. My son, Robert, Ashley, and our little one, Kristopher.
Okay, so tell us why you're here.
We're here because my son, Kristopher, needs a liver transplant, and he's on the waiting list now, waiting for a liver transplant. And we're hoping that this walk will bring awareness to people to donate their organs for that people aren't using them, to let people like my son have them. He was born with a condition called biliary atresia, and what that is, he was born without a common bile duct, so he needs the whole liver to survive.
So, how has it affected your family?
It's been real tough, because you don't know the outcome and what's going to happen, and you know, losing one of your children is not an easy thing to have, and especially for people that have to donate their organs as well, but to know that if they do, that a guy like him can keep going on in life, and that the people who donate their organs, they piece of them will continue living on the people that get the organs. So
does anyone else want to comment on how it's affected you sometimes?
No.
Very emotional.
Everybody's shy.
Yeah? I'm very emotional. It must be hard, especially as a parent.
Yes, it's been a long 12 years.
I'm sure it was.
Yeah. Yeah, we're up
and
down.
He's a fairly good person.
Yeah.
Well, yes. Right now we're waiting for the transplant. There's nothing else they can do for him to keep him going. We're waiting for the liver. He's got a pager that he has to carry with him. Show him the pager. That's his pager life, right there. That's in London Sick Children's Hospital.
So how does it feel to carry around a pager?
Cool.
Still a beat.
Yeah.
Has it ever gone off?
Yeah, but with the new technology now, you can see the number and call it back. So it's in the a while back, they used to have only pagers that just beeped, and when they rang, you had to call the hospital to find out if that was you. And most of the time, it was a false alarm, and that caused a lot of stress. At least with this one now, you can call the number back and know right away who it is, if it's a false alarm or what. So
where is he on the waiting list?
We're waiting. Hopefully, anytime when. Whenever it comes. Yeah. It's a slow, long process. Yeah. Really slow.
How do you feel about what George has done?
I think he's done a great thing, and if it can continue on, it would be even better. The more people to sign and be aware to let people like him continue on in life, the better. You know, people like him deserve a chance to live. They don't all, not all are bad.
What's
That there's not enough, and a lot of hospitals aren't equipped to do it. If they were ready, they've got to get something in place so that if people are willing and wanting to, that it's ready to go, and not just in big cities. It has to be in smaller cities, or make arrangements to get them to the big cities where they can make use of the organs that are available. Well, exactly what George is doing. Have a national list, and if you don't want to be on the list, opt to sign yourself off the list, and that way everybody's aware that when you die, your body's going to go of some use, and other people can continue on living.
So what do you do as a family to scrub
the world? We wear our own t-shirt, our same t-shirts, and we try to go to all the rallies we can go to and get it out there that this is what we need to do, is make people sign their organ donor cards and make their families aware of their wishes. Because a lot of times somebody's willing to donate their organs, but their family doesn't know that they're willing to donate their organs. And when it comes time that they do pass, their organs, they wanted to donate them, but their family says no because they weren't sure of what the wishes were of their person that wanted to donate the organs, so they can't donate their organs. So make everybody aware and sure that that's what you want to do. And when it does come, that's what can happen.
Have you ever considered the living donors for liver?
Oh yeah, well, for his situation it won't work because he needs the tubes to hook everything together, but for people that it does work, I think that's fabulous. And for people that match and are able to donate, it's a wonderful thing. An organ and tissue donation is a genuine act of love throughout the world, so wonderful. Just what his shirt says, and his shirt says, please don't take your organs to heaven. Heaven knows we need them here. And thanks.
Thank you very much.
Good afternoon. Here, I'm going to go like this. That's okay? Hold it. Thanks. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm pleased to be here on behalf of our mayor, Mel Lastman, and my colleagues on City Council, to welcome George at the end of his walk across this country, around the world. Toronto is, and to welcome you to Nathan Phillips Square. Toronto is really blessed by a lot of good things. We have good neighborhoods, we have a lot of good physical architecture, but primarily we are blessed with the strength of our citizens, and George is certainly an example of that.
What? son Stuart was a living donor. So we want to make an awareness that living donor is an option available to some of the people with severe liver damage. Stuart was the same blood type. He was a match and he was healthy enough to go through this operation. But had Stuart not been a match, my friend Brian Patterson here, he had offered to give me a piece of his liver. And it's very, very humbling to be in a position like I am, to have two, well, my son and my friend, offer to donate the liver. So I am very, very, very thankful. And I live life with a renewed zeal, because it was very sick for 2 years. I woke up on June the 2nd feeling great. And we're on demand. Stuart's back at work full time. And I'm starting to enjoy my retirement. So I'll pass over to Stuart for a few words.
I'd just like to say one thing. The thing I noticed through this whole ordeal is how much a positive attitude helps. It got us through this. I was sure when all this started that everything would work out, and it did. Never had any doubt in my mind. So I think that's the way to go. Just stay positive and hopefully things will work out for you. Thank you.
And Brian Patterson is here too.
I'm doubly blessed that Stuart was a perfect match, and the operation wasn't required on my part. But Al Stark's one of those kind of guys that you can step up to the plate for. And if more people knew the opportunity, Stuart was back to work in 3 weeks. So it'd be like taking a vacation and helping a friend. And frankly, watching Stuart and Al 2 days after the operation, they turned the life switch back on Al. And it's just been it's been amazing. And 10K after 7 weeks is just outstanding. So well done, and God bless.
Chef Bruce, I want to first give my congratulations to George. I think George is amazing. He had a vision and a belief, and he had faith. And he put it all together and brought people together from all over the country and enough money to do it. And had determination. And sometimes when you have a vision and faith like that, you get it done, even without a big plan beforehand. And we're all here in all the media because of George. And 2 years ago in Hyde Park, who would have known that it would have been this successful? And I think we should all give a huge round of applause to George personally. And when I was growing up, my friend Stuart Lockwood, who was my best friend, was very sick. He had a genetic kidney disease, and he got a kidney transplant from his father, the reverse. His father helped him out.
Around and we make plans to go to the beach, we go here. How about taking a little bit of time making a plan for the future of somebody else? And that's what I'm going to do. I'm signing my donor card. And what I'm doing here, I want to help George create awareness. This is a very important thing. We shouldn't have 4,000 people waiting for us. This young fellow here waiting 12 years shouldn't have to wait 12 years. So I'm just helping to create awareness, and if I can help, all the better for George. And I'm glad to be here and be part of this. I just want to leave you with this little message. May you live 100 years and ask for a shoe.
On June 20th, 2000, supporting George and giving him his send-off, my son was in the hospital, ready to be transported to Toronto General Hospital to give the gift of life and tissue. My name is Debbie. I am a donor mom. I have the incredible honor of telling you how I met George Marcello. Well, I discovered Step by Step's website on January 2nd, 2002, when I was surfing the net to find out what was going on in the organ transplant world. His final wish come true. Mayor Mel Lastman was presenting George to make our, or to presenting George with the torch of life to start his walk. I emailed Elaine, George's assistant, to tell her of our amazing coincidence. The very same day George started his walk a year and a half ago,
my son Michael, at 26, ended up brain dead from a serious fall in his home. I couldn't believe George was still out there fighting the winter elements. He was so inspired by my email. George asked if he could come to our community to honor our son Michael on the second anniversary of Step by Step's walk and Michael's gift of life and tissue to so many. I am proud to say Michael has given the gift of life and tissue to 32 people.
So my husband, being the great artist that he is, we are giving George a painting. And Debbie is going to unveil the painting for us. He can put it on the wall of his new office, because I think mine's sort of going to be going on halftime now.
Hello. I very much enjoyed walking with you all today. My name is Stuart Gray. 8 years ago, about now, my son required a kidney, and in fact, at that time, I donated one to him. It was no big deal. And I'm, as you'll see today, I'm still pretty fit and can blow the pipes on your march. So if any of you are considering donating, it's not any big deal. Thank you.
Did you want to play a special tune for us? Are you going to do it? You going to do it over there? Come up front so everybody can. This is always a treat. Lord, we know that there's life and then there's death. But Lord, because of the doctors and all the latest things in science now, people can still live. Your word says if any two of us should agree, is having just anything that we ask, should be done for us by our Father which is in heaven. Right now, we all agree that heart donations and organ transplants are important. We all agree right now and asking you to give a transplant to Chris. We all agree right now for a transplant today for Frank. We all agree that a national registry system will be put in place. If everybody here agrees with what I just said, say amen. Amen. That's an agreement. Therefore, I believe we receive it. I ask these things in the name of your son. Amen.
Like we're going to be hammering away at whoever we need to hammer away. To debate me on this, I want to hear a good argument why we shouldn't have it, and you know the walk proved that, excuse me, that the public's behind this precious consent. So now I know I can move forward with it with the public behind me. What did I learn? That. I drive people crazy, and that, but a lot of people put up with me, and that I learned how to talk French. Est-ce que vous parlez-vous anglais? Learned how to get scorched
in Newfoundland. I learned how to do sweats. And it's been a learning experience.
You don't feel a sense of achievement?
No, I don't. Everybody's been asking me that. Every television station that came up, you know, said, do you feel like... And honestly, I don't. I feel like I only got the job half done, you know.
That's where
phase
two is next?
Phase two has to kick in, man. Like...
So the walk is just the beginning?
The walk was just to plant the seeds across the country, to sprinkle out the seeds. And phase two is going to make sure to nourish these seeds so that they can grow. And I won't be finished until Canada rises from the bottom to the top. Then now I'm finished. It was on your camera that I said I was going to visit the Pope, right? Wasn't it?
Yeah, many times.
It was, yeah. And everybody kept saying not to say that, like that, you know, that you can't say something that didn't happen, right? But I had this little feeling it was going to happen. So I said it, and I kept saying it. So I'm going to keep saying this. In 4 years, Canada's going to rise from the bottom to the top. You might be an unfortunate person to have a vision. And if you have a vision to try and get something done, something that's inside of you that you want to get done, you'll fall into two categories. When it gets too hard or it gets too, you'll just give up. But if you have a little bit of insanity in your life, then you might stick it through. So there's no other way to explain right now how I got this done, except that I'm a little crazy.
Footage, because the important part is going to come up, so just take like little, a few seconds, you know?
Okay.
Keep...
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, next one. Okay.
Right out of the way, my friend.
One more, hang on.
Okay, I gotta frills. Beautiful.
Woo.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Andrea. Thank you, Vittorio. I have more than a trio. We have another young lady who's joined us. Everybody knows George Marcello. You've been on the show many, many times talking about your wonderful cause, organ and tissue donation awareness. And I'm very thrilled to have with me a young man. His name is Kristopher Knowles. And Kristopher met George Marcello when George was walking across Canada in Kristopher's hometown of Sarnia, Ontario. It's about 3 hours away from Toronto. Kristopher suffers from liver disease, and he has been on the organ transplant waiting list for his entire life. At age of 6 months, Kristopher's family was told that Kristopher would require a liver transplant. This is Kristopher. Hi, Kristopher.
Hi.
Welcome to the show. So the obvious question that I asked George and I asked you before the interview is, when your parents met George, they didn't run away thinking he was a crazy maniac for walking across Canada for his cause, a good cause, but it was a heck of a trek. And you said, no, your parents thought George was terrific. Walking for a cause that is obviously of your life's importance. And you expressed what to George at that time?
I was looking forward to doing it with him because he inspired me to do it, because he had a liver transplant and he was like the same as me, so.
So Kristopher, you're on the waiting list and you've just won the 800 and 1500 meter races at your school.
Yeah.
So you're a fast runner.
Yep.
Walking is just not a problem for you.
Nope.
You're going to hit 350 cities across Canada?
Yep.
That should be one of our questions, you know, to know that there are at least 350 cities in Canada, and Chris will be walking in each one of them. George, how do you feel about Chris?
Well, you know, along the way, Danine, I met a lot of people that were on the waiting list and donor families, and, you know, I got left with a lot of memories. But when I met Chris, he stood out. The courage and the determination and the spirit that this young teenager has is just incredible. I think as soon as I met him, I knew he was going to get his way. He wanted to walk across Canada, and I knew he was going to get his way. So when he asked me to be his road manager, I agreed, you know. You know, this is going to be a little different because we have to take a few more safety precautions along the way. So we're going to have a registered nurse on board this time and a tutor to make sure he's not missing any classes, which is important to education. And, you know, we'll be all set to go.
Well, it's funny, George, because when you introduced us to Kristopher, and Kristopher was there to welcome you when you on your final homecoming from your walk across Canada, we all said, well, what do you mean? Because how many times did I talk to you on your cell phone as you were trekking across the Trans-Canada Highway through, like, Saskatchewan in the dead of winter? And you said, you can't avoid winter in Canada, so you're taking all the precautions for Kristopher. We saw you with the Pope, the Prime Minister, all sorts of wonderful things ahead of you, Kristopher. And so many people admire your strength, your courage. You've got the most beautiful smile I've ever seen. I wish you well. We all wish you well, and there are all sorts of ways to support your journey. It's called The Next Step. George's walk was called Step by Step, and this is The Next Step, Kristopher's Wish, trekking across Canada for organ and tissue donations, January 8th through to December 25th. Christmas Day is when you end it. You're kicking off Sarnia, going to Victoria, and then you're doing St. John's, Newfoundland, back to Sarnia. So lots of ways to help. Is there a phone number that we can ask people to call if they'd like to know how they can help?
Yes, presently they can reach me at 416-540-7872 or visit our website at www.stepbystep.ca. Or email me at gmarcello@rogers.com. And before we sign off, Chris has something to say that he's been practicing all morning with.
Tiborio, Tivorio, Benny, Asai, Asai.
Oh, thank you, Kristopher. That's really sweet. Yeah, you're bringing tears to my eyes. Kristopher, you have surgery on Tuesday?
Yeah.
You're incredible. Kristopher Knowles, we're very proud to have you here. And George, your family's behind you.
Yes, this is my niece, Alessia Grecki. She's going to be a famous singer one day.
Well, thank you very much. You'll keep us posted, George.
Yes.
Good luck, Kristopher. Thanks. With your surgery on Tuesday. You're a brave kid, and you have a wonderful family, Victoria and Andrea.
Thank you.
Hi, we're back. You know what? That was a wonderful interview, Danina, and to all of them, we wish them the very best, because I hear he's going for surgery soon, so good luck with him in his surgery.
Volevo dire una cosa. Il bello della diretta, non eravamo in onda, poi non eravamo in onda.
Yeah.
Cioè, questa è la vita, è bello, perché dimostriamo al mondo che anche noi siamo umani.
Yeah, yeah. Cioè, and it really makes, you know, it's unfortunate that it's at times like this when we realize that, but you realize how, like you said, how important life is, and how little things are so not important, are not important, and yet we focus on materialistic things, and but meanwhile, you know, just being alive and breathing and smiling and being with friends is the most
la cosa
important
più bella.
Yes, it is. Okay.
Allora,
A Sarnia teen is looking for a new liver, and he's willing to walk across Canada to find one. CKCO's Jim Alexander tells us about Kristopher Knowles, who shared his dream with high school students in Guelph this morning.
Hi, my name is Kristopher Knowles. I'm 13 years old, and I'm waiting for a liver transplant. I have a wish. My wish is to walk across Canada to help 4,000 Canadians that also need liver transplant.
A riveting message for students at Guelph Collegiate, someone their age in a race against liver disease. It's a race George Marcello won several years ago when he received a transplant and began walking across Canada to raise awareness about organ donation. It's a trip Kristopher will start next January with support from Guelph's mayor, Karen Farbridge, who had George and Kristopher sign her donor card as witnesses.
Thank you very much, and when you get this card, fill it out and sign it and have someone witness it.
For Kristopher, the goal is to improve this country's low rate of organ donors.
Yes, it does bother me because people need to live, and like they need to help other people. That if people die, they need to help other people so they can live.
For many of these GCVI students, meeting Kristopher Knowles is the first close-up look they've had at the issue of organ donation. Student well-wishers reached out for the torch and the message Kristopher will carry.
Hopefully it'll inspire others to do the same. The best way to lead is to lead by example, and I think they're doing a good job, so hopefully people will listen to them.
Yeah, I was very surprised that our country's one of the lowest, and I think it's a great thing for people to do, and it's not that hard to just sign a card and get it done.
Sometimes things have a way of just being forgotten the next day, but I'm sure looking at those students that something was left with them, and that's what we're saying. We're hoping to plant the seeds.
Kristopher carries the torch and his wish back through Guelph January 23rd. Jim Alexander, CKCO News, Guelph.
Are your friend.
Right. Well, no separate account, whatever, but...
But you'll see. You'll see. You can track it down.
She wouldn't mind the tax receipt.
Yeah. I will send that to you right away.
Elaine. She definitely wants
it. Yeah. Elaine will send them out.
It's my boss.
Okay.
Yeah. She'll get it in about 3 days. Is that okay?
Well, no hurry.
Oh, no, no. That's fine.
Okay.
No, I just want to tell you what happened today.
Okay.
I work for a non-profit, government-funded corporation. We're funded equally by the feds and the province of Ontario, MTCU, Ministry of Training, Colleges and Universities, and HRDC, Human Resources Development Canada. We have a board of directors that is made up of people in the community who represent several different labor market sectors, labor, business, the equity groups, visible minorities, people with disabilities, Francophones, mm-hmm. women, so on and so forth. So tonight was a
board meeting.
And I asked my executive director to approach the executive committee and ask them if I could make a presentation on behalf of Chris and Step by Step and Kristopher's Wish.
Slipped it in there, eh?
And the executive said, yes, by all means, we think that's great. So today what I did during the day is I set up a display of newspaper articles, Kristopher's posters, pamphlets. I copied the pamphlets and sponsor sheets. And so prior to the board meeting starting and the regular agenda, they allowed me to introduce Kristopher.
Kristopher there?
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, Kristopher King.
Wow.
And we didn't have a full slate tonight, but we had a good, did you count, Chris? Maybe 16, 17 people around the room there. Mm-hmm. A couple of government representatives as well. So I introduced Kristopher, I explained how I know Kristopher and his whole family and how much a part of our lives, my husband and I, they all are. And then I explained his physical condition and his journey, his track, the next little piece that he's about to embark on. It was a captive audience, people were really paying attention. And after we got through the piece, and I told all about how we met you, how you and Step by Step have taken on this Kristopher's Wish, seeking sponsorship, but the main focus, awareness about organ donation. I had organ donation cards there. I had the green ribbons there. I had photocopies of newspaper articles there. Article about critical Chris's physical condition, biliary atresia, so on and so forth. They were captive. They were interested. And when I said at the very end, would you like to ask Christopher any questions? I mean, there were hands shooting up around the room. And they asked, you know, Christopher, were you born with this condition? They wanted to know more about that. They wanted to know how much money we wanted to raise. They wanted to know, they asked, have you been out and spoken to all of the Chemical Valley partners, all the big business in Chemical Valley, Sarnia? Have you been out to the organized churches? They wanted to know where we've been so far. And immediately, as soon as we were done, Christopher got handed a check. I was asked, you know, who do we make the checks out to? And I explained that Step by Step is a charitable organization. Christopher got handed a check. I got handed a card from the president of the Sarnia District Labor Council. So all of the labor associations affiliated there, they're having a general meeting on December 16. They'd like us to come.
Wow.
Yeah, and they want Chris to come. And, okay, so they'd like that. And
they want Kathleen to do the presentation.
We'll get back to that later. Then I got asked by Jeffrey Moore, who is the president of Fibrex Insulations here at Fibrex Insulations, big company, big employer, manufacturing, and John Payne, he's retired from Bear Inc. Right? They asked who we had approached in the large Chemical Valley employers, and I said, well, I know that Kelly had done a bit of a campaign with Shell and Imperial, but we hadn't had much luck. They said, we want you to come to the next IEC meeting, which is Industrial Educational Cooperative, and that is a cooperative made up of 19 Chemical Valley employers.
It's okay.
Dalton McGinty is banning cell phones.
No, it's okay.
Anyway, IEC, Industrial Educational Cooperative, is a membership of 19 large Chemical Valley employers here in town. They have their general meeting next Wednesday morning at 8 a.m. And these two gentlemen are members of that council. And they have asked me to call the general manager tomorrow, John Barfield, and see if we can get it on the agenda to come and do a presentation there to them. Though that's Bear, Shell, Nova, Imperial Oil, Air
ones.
Products, all of them in the
Cabot.
Cabot.
And
one man. Those are upper management that go to those meetings.
Right, they're the ones
they're
that
either
commit the
human
decisions.
Resources or their VPs, and they're going to be there at that meeting. So I still have to get that on the agenda.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
But I think that can be done. No, now that's next Wednesday morning, 8 a.m.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, perfect. Wow. Okay, so did you want to spearhead doing the presentations and everything?
Oh, gosh, Chris, I'm awful, are I not?
Well, you seem to be okay today.
He's good.
If anybody was going to represent me
and my family and step by step, I would love it for you to be you.
I love that you say that.
I mean, I was speaking from love today,
yeah. But I was speaking with people that I know.
No.
And even with them, I got nervous.
No way. And even if it does fail, the fact that we got 15 minutes of their time.
Yeah, they're still going to hear it.
The fact that we got 15 minutes of their time is
horrifying.
I said to Kel, tonight, both Chris and I thought it went really well. And I said, I think the fallout from tonight, it's going to come two to three weeks down the road because we left all the information there. Yeah. And we said, go ahead with your meeting, but here's the news clippings, here's the donor cards, here's the ribbons, here's the sponsor sheets.
I had only a small package, but we left it all behind.
Okay, so here's just what I'm suggesting. The first meeting is next week.
The IEC Wednesday morning. I have to get us on the agenda first. I have to speak to the general manager.
No, I don't have to be there.
But if you're here, it would be very beneficial
to answer the questions that they're asking of her because she's not
okay.
That aware.
I could be there.
So that's six and one half dozen the other.
Yeah, exactly. Okay,
it'd be good if you could be there in the background, even if you don't speak a word. If they've got something that she can't answer, at least you can
I'll be there to back you up.
So they can do that.
I'll fill in any holes that come up.
If there's any
holes. I won't wear my pajama flannels.
You won't? Why not? What's wrong with your pajama flannel?
It just doesn't go. It just doesn't go.
That's the neighbor. We don't care.
Yeah, she's fresh out of the town.
Okay, so what dates are we looking at next week?
Next week, Wednesday. I think that's December 3 or 4. What is it?
December 6 is the parade.
Okay.
December 16 is the
IEC.
Sorry, my coffee.
That's okay. We're going to hit them up for
and
a big sponsorship, too.
I love Timmy.
His little note said that, you know, Chris would make an excellent guest speaker. Now, Chris, he cringed when he heard that, and I said, no, I don't think they're going to expect you, Chris, to get up and make a speech, but maybe somebody could speak on your behalf, and you could answer. Chris was fantastic today when I said, does anybody have any questions for Chris? And they did. They did. It was great.
Yeah.
It was super. You were quite comfortable, were you not?
Yeah.
No problem. So, okay, just let me know what dates, and so I'll...
Wednesday? 8 a.m.
8 a.m.
That's next Wednesday. Okay. And the next one is December 16 at 7:30 p.m.
Okay. Okay, perfect.
Right on.
All righty.
Well, hopefully
that, good work.
That helps.
Well,
and the other thing that we did is we asked these folks, I asked them to take the pamphlet, the brochure, any information that was left up on the table for them, back to their church, back to their any organization they belong to, back to their business, to see if they can get some people to either support by signing an organ donation card or deciding to contribute financially to the expenses for the walk.
Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make another brochure, and this one's going to be just on the kickoff. So that has all the details on, for the kickoff.
Okay.
And we'll make a lot of, we won't make them too fancy, just straightforward.
Get the
we can get as many people to come out on the 8th as possible. And just have to confirm the, I have a tentative that we're starting at City Hall at 12:30 to walk to Johnston.
Okay.
But in case, like, the break comes on, or,
or somehow,
we
change.
Might.
I think the IEC will be the main one.
Okay,
so
whoever.
Plan on doing that?
I think Chin's are.
Yeah, we still got time to change the tentative.
Like no, I just meant a time to have you got a time that you're going to start off.
About 12:30. We'll put in, like, about 5-6 kilometers that day, you know.
Right.
Nice little.
We got to think of something. What? Because now that Skits is doing their thing, St. Pat's is having a thing.
To recognize all them.
McKenzie's having a thing. Yeah, we either going to have to do a little press conference at each one of those schools.
Well, what we can do is then
find a way.
We can find a route. Because we did this in Toronto that way because we had the same thing happening.
Right.
We could connect the dots, start from somewhere, connect the dots, and end up at Johnston at the end of the day.
That would be pretty... Well, Alexander McKenzie's quite the walk from...
Is it?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, God, yeah.
Okay, so we might have to somehow...
15K.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, what we can do is ask them to send out some kids holding up one of their banners.
Right.
To come out and represent the school.
Because that's just the girls' soccer team.
Soccer team, just get the soccer team.
That's not got anything to do with the school yet. Yeah, I understand that, but we don't know if they're coming on board or not.
George, I also want to mention to you that one of the questions around the table from one of the board of directors was, are you involved with the SODA organization, Sarnia Organ Donor Awareness? They asked Chris that, and Chris said, well, I think so, but I'm not sure. And I said, I know that the family has been, and I know that when they go to visit each of the cities and towns they go to, they get the local organ donor awareness organizations involved. But the other reason, the other thing that they asked, we kind of indicated, they were wondering why they hadn't heard more about this in Sarnia yet. And I said, well, interestingly enough, it appears it's been getting some really good publicity in the Toronto area because Chin is one of their sponsors, and people around the table nodded. They knew who Chin was. I explained to others that it was the cultural radio television out of Toronto. But that's when the interest around the room really peaked, and they said, well, here's what we can do locally. Like, they want to get the local involvement.
Here's what's happening. We're having this press conference tomorrow, and that's going to bring it out in the community that much more.
Right.
And from that point, it's going to keep building. On the 18th of December, we're having our big launch at Queen's Park. And what Queen's Park did, and they usually don't do this unless it's emergencies or some breaking news in the province or the country, they gave us the main media room to make our announcement. We're going to be hooked into every media outlet around the world.
Okay.
And that is big. And we got the Minister of Education. He's going to get the Premier to come out. He's, you know, we got the heavies on that day.
Okay. That's really good, because that's 2 days after the Sarnia District Labor Council
meeting. And we can invite some of them to attend that.
Yeah,
and one of the things I thought today, when we did this little bit with the Board of Directors today, is that tomorrow, Chris's thing is going to happen at Skits. And it's going to be in the paper and on the radio tomorrow. Those folks that were around the table tonight, I think, will feel they have a bit of ownership around the whole venture, because they met Chris before that, right? Yeah. They're going to feel a bit of ownership around it.
Yeah.
Same with the Sarnia District Labor Council. Hopefully, the unions here in town are so supportive of community they're just hugely supportive.
Huge.
They put lots of money towards community support. So if you meet with them on the 16th and that's coming out on the 18th, I think that's really
part
good
of what's
going
to happen from this is we're going to put Sarnia even more on the map because of Chris. Because of Chris, Sarnia is going to be mentioned constantly. And it's going to be like
Mike
Boy
here,
Boy Tom.
What's his name?
Kim Mitchell.
Yeah.
So what we're saying is Christopher is going to be the next big Sarnia thing. You know, he's going to be the next big, and that's how it's going to develop. And all these people can get behind it.
Yeah.
You know, they can show
them.
Yeah.
I think they will.
Yeah.
They got to meet him.
Yeah. So that's great. That's great. They're aware of it now, and we're just following the steps.
We just need a few more folks doing the same thing, eh? Going to their own board of directors and doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Inside. That's what we need, inside.
Mm-hmm. When I was talking about his condition, I said, Christopher has written a poem about his scar. Well, I mentioned the 15 surgeries and 13 years, and I said, he's written a poem about his scars. It's up here on the wall for you folks to all read. And I said, and you got a good mark on that in school, didn't you, Chris? And he said, yeah. And I said, and who helped you write that poem, I said? He said, you.
Who wrote the poem for you, Chris?
Mm-mm.
No, he wrote it out. She just helped with words and how to use on the computer, right?
The rhyming.
Yeah.
Just the rhyming.
Okay, and we're rolling.
Denise Seller.
No. Hi, my name is.
Oh, you want it like that?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. I thought you were just going to do a test. Okay.
No. Okay.
Hi, my name is Denise Seller. I'm manager of the Harborfront Inn in Sarnia.
Okay, and could you tell me how you found out about Kristopher's Wish, and if you could put that in the context of, I found out about Kristopher's Wish.
I found out about Kristopher's Wish when I was contacted by George Marcello, who is a wonderful advocate for organ donation. He had did his run across Canada last spring and had approached us about accommodation, and we were glad to help him. When he got a hold of me this past week and asked about rooms again to help out for this wonderful campaign, we were more than happy to do it. And with such a young fella here in our own city, we just couldn't say no. And George, being the wonderful person that he is, we were happy to help out so that we could get Kristopher's Wish up and running.
Okay.
Okay. Center of the ball. Two doors down for people to remember. Okay, see you in about 15 minutes.
Stuff to 208. Yeah, I'll meet you guys up there. Excited today?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, excited for your brother?
Yep.
Yeah. So, you've lived with your brother your whole life. I mean, he was a baby when you were just a young child.
Yes.
How did this affect you? Can you tell me what you were feeling as a young child up to today?
I didn't really realize what was going on until a little later in life when my brother started having surgery and stuff. And then it kind of affected me because a few times he was in danger when he had this belly cut open again, and I forget what it was, torn shut, and I had to, it was kind of hard for me because my mom said he might not go through well through this, and they were saying stuff. So.
What's the Warren shunt? Do you remember what?
They had to put this thing in to pump blood into his heart so his heart would stay pumping until he gets his liver, but I heard it didn't turn out.
So Chris is a very active young boy. You never see him like looking sick or that. I'm sure you do.
He's really active, but when he's hurt, he doesn't tell anybody. He holds it in, and we're trying to tell him to tell us, so because in case anything happened, like he was feeling sick the other day, he told my mom. Like he had 101 fever. So it's just because of the sin, not pumping.
So does this affect the way you two treat each other sometimes?
No, or do you still really. We still play like kids. We still play tackle football. We play normal sports.
You still kids. Beat them up?
Still, we're not necessarily beat them up because I don't do anything to them. Like,
right.
I hit him and I slap him, or like, not hard, just playing around
yeah.
and stuff. And then we just play like normal kids.
Yeah.
But I just know where not to hit him and do anything like that. Like, we don't even hit each other. He hits me, but I don't hit him.
Well, the problem was that.
An exciting couple of weeks.
Yes.
Okay, yes, the kids are ready.
So all players feel awesome.
Just gonna ask Mrs. Buchanan about the school's involvement in Kristopher's Wish, her impression of, you know, so basically that's it. If you could just tell me how the school became involved with Kristopher's Wish and how you feel about the project.
Okay. George originally contacted me to let me know that this was happening. And Skits was very excited to become part of Kristopher's Wish. Kristopher's Wish is unbelievable. I think about a 13-year-old boy going on a walk across Canada, and it's just absolutely incredible. And Skits students are tremendously aware of things that happen around them, and they always jump on anything that they can become involved in. They're very enthusiastic. They never let me down. They're a wonderful group. The staff and students here are terrific. And to be able to support a student who will be coming here next year and whose siblings are presently here is just a really great opportunity for all of us.
Good morning, and welcome to Sarnia Collegiate Institute and Technical School. My name is Mrs. Roberta Buchanan, and I am honored as the principal of Sarnia Collegiate to welcome each of you and our special guests to this very special assembly. Thank you, Ms. Patton and the band. You were awesome this morning. Thank you very, very much. Skip is honored to have several guests with us this morning. Mrs. Mattingly, our Superintendent of Education, the Honorable Mike Bradley, Mayor of Sarnia, Dean Stewartson, Director for the SODA, Connie Ellis, Chairperson for the SODA, George Martello, Kristopher's Road Manager for his cross-country walk, the Knowles family, who are Kristopher's greatest supporters, last but certainly not least, Kristopher Knowles. As you know, this morning's assembly is unlike many of our regular gatherings. At Skits, we work as a family, supporting each other, recognizing accomplishments, acknowledging strengths, and always striving to excel. That is our wish, to excel in all that we can, to be a strong community in which to learn and grow. Today, this community is assembled to support the courage of one young man who many of you may not yet know. We have heard of Kristopher over the past few weeks. Some of you do know him. Many of you know his brother and sister. Kristopher is a young man who has made a wish, a grand wish, with the potential to help thousands of people. One person has made a wish, and a host of family and friends have offered their support in assisting him in achieving his goal. We are here this morning to wish Kristopher the very best in his walk across Canada, to raise awareness for organ donation. Now, wait a minute. Stop and think about what I just said. Kristopher, a 13-year-old, soon to be Skits grade, not student. is walking across Canada. Wow. Isn't that unbelievable? This is an unbelievable goal for any person. But even more incredible, when you consider that Kristopher is only 13 years old. His wish to raise awareness about organ donations is so very important. I have carried my organ donation card with me since I began to drive, and I'm not going to tell you how long ago that was. It is looking a little ragged. I brought it with me this morning, and it's kind of torn up and so on. But you know, the message is clear without one little card. More importantly, I have talked to my family about my wishes, and they know that I have signed my organ donation card.
This morning, you will have an opportunity to listen to information regarding this important issue. We are fortunate to have Kristopher and his family join with us this morning. It is with sincere pleasure that I welcome Kristopher, our special guests, and each of you to this morning's assembly. I would now like to introduce our Superintendent of Education, Mrs. Madeline. Christopher, great success in realizing his dream to walk across Canada in support of organ and tissue donations. Christopher, your courage and vision is an inspiration to all of us. I'm very pleased that Sarnia Collegiate is hosting this event. As a graduate of SCITS, I know that this school always has had a legacy of caring and demonstrating true heart and soul. I know that the students and staff of this school and all of us in the Lambton-Kent District School Board are behind you 100%, Christopher. It's only by working together that we can make a difference in this world. Thank you, Christopher, for showing us all the importance of having a goal and having the courage to pursue your dreams. Christopher, on behalf of the Lambton-Kent District School Board, I wish you great success.
Awareness of organ organ and tissue donation is a very important subject. And I'm here on behalf of the Society Organ Donor Awareness Group to wish Chris lots of success and to acknowledge and thank you.
Cross-country walk, the Knowles family, who are Kristopher's greatest supporters, last but certainly not least, Kristopher Knowles. As you know, this morning's assembly is unlike many of our regular gatherings. At Skits, we work as a family, supporting each other, recognizing accomplishments, acknowledging strengths, and always striving to excel. That is our wish, to excel in all that we can, to be a strong community in which to learn and grow. Today, this community is assembled to support the courage of one young man who many of you may not yet know. We have heard of Kristopher over the past few weeks. Some of you do know him. Many of you know his brother and sister. Kristopher is a young man who has made a wish, a grand wish, with the potential to help thousands of people. One person has made a wish, and a host of family and friends have offered their support in assisting him in achieving his goal. We are here this morning to wish Kristopher the very best in his walk across Canada, to raise awareness for organ donation. Now, wait a minute. Stop and think about what I just said. Kristopher, a 13-year-old, soon to be Skits grade 9, soon. Is walking across Canada. Wow, isn't that unbelievable? This is an unbelievable goal for any person. But even more incredible, when you consider Kristopher is only 13 years old. His wish to raise awareness about organ donations is so very important. I have carried my organ donation card with me since I began to drive, and I'm not going to tell you how long ago that was. It is looking a little ragged, and I brought it with me this morning, and it's kind of torn up and so on. But you know, the message is clear without one little card. More importantly, I have talked to my family about my wishes, and they know that I have signed my organ donation card. The
have an opportunity to listen to information regarding this important issue. We are fortunate to have Kristopher and his family join with us this morning. It is with sincere pleasure that I welcome Kristopher, our special guests, and each of you to this morning's assembly. I would now like to introduce our Superintendent of Education, Mrs. Madeline. Donations. Kristopher, your courage and vision is an inspiration to all of us. I'm very pleased that Sarnia Collegiate is hosting this event. As a graduate of SCITS, I know that this school always has had a legacy of caring and demonstrating true heart and soul. I know that the students and staff of this school and all of us in the Lampen Kent District School Board are behind you 100%, Kristopher. It's only by working together that we can make a difference in this world. Thank you, Kristopher, for showing us all the importance of having a goal and having the courage to pursue your dreams. Kristopher, on behalf of the Lampen Kent District School Board, I wish you great success.
Very important.
importance of it. And I'm here on behalf of the Saudi Organ Donor Awareness Group to wish Chris lots of success and to acknowledge and thank you. But Skits really is the best school anywhere, ever. And the Skits students and staff has raised a total of $2,000 for Kristopher's Wish.
Thank you.
whole family on this side, and we'll just work back away. Come on. Stand up and just file past Kristopher so that everybody has an opportunity.
Yeah. I'm Darwin Keeley, president of the Trillium Gift of Life Network, and we're here this afternoon for a couple of reasons. First, to support Kristopher, and to really express our admiration and strength for this young man from Sarnia. Kristopher is 13 years old. He suffers from liver disease, and he's one of the 1,771 people on the waiting list, waiting for an organ to be transplanted. And Chris's reality is as follows. So far this year, 116 people, Ontario residents, have died waiting for an organ to be transplanted. So we're here to support him in a very real way. We're here because he wants to do something about it. He represents hope for those who are on the waiting list. And he wants to do something about raising the awareness about organ and tissue donation. And he's here to launch his Cross Canada tour for that purpose. We're here, Chris, because we want to help you make your dream come true. And we're very pleased, or I'm very pleased to call on Carolyn DeCoco, the MPP from Sarnia Lambton, Chris's home riding, to join in with her personal support.
Thank you. And I, first of all, thank you very much. And it's a pleasure to be able to participate in this important event today. And as the member of Provincial Parliament for Sarnia Lambton, I'm proud to have a constituent like Kristopher, and I'm here to support Kristopher. Kristopher's an amazing young man who's shown a tremendous amount of courage, both in his own personal circumstances and bringing awareness to this important issue. As a representative of the Ontario government, I'm pleased to say that we're fully supportive of Kristopher as he embarks on his cross-country walking tour next month. And I'm also, I'm pleased that we have here today as well the Minister of Children's Services, Honourable Marie Butriani's here. And we also, I have to say that I also met Marcello a number of years ago in Sarnia when he did his run for transplants. This issue, yesterday I raised it in the House, and we've had an opportunity over the last few days to raise this issue with my colleagues from all of the parties. I've written to all of them about Kristopher's wish, and I've spoken in the House on this issue, and you have the support of my colleagues of all political stripes. And it's been overwhelming and very encouraging. I want you to know, Kristopher, you have the support of all of us here at Queen's Park. So I want to thank the organizers, George and Marcello particularly, for their hard work on this issue. Today is setting up this event in years past and for the hard work that lies ahead. And most of all, thank you, Kristopher. His family is here. Kelly Knoll, Kelly, Sandy, Ashley, and Robert, thank you for taking the
to call on George Marcello to lend his support. As some of you know, George is a liver recipient. He is the founder and leader of Step by Step, a community organization, foundation promoting organ and tissue donation. And he's been intimately involved in the details of the organization of Kristopher's Wish. George.
Good afternoon. On behalf of Step by Step, it is my pleasure to inspire you about Kristopher's wish. His story. Reaching your 13th birthday is not a milestone for most people, but for Kristopher Knowles and his family, it's a cause for celebration. Kristopher was born in 9 weeks early on April 29, 1990 at St. Joseph's Hospital, London, Ontario. After undergoing several life-saving surgeries, Kristopher developed a yellowish tinge to his skin that was initially attributed to other health complications. When the yellowish hue failed to disappear after several months, tests revealed that Kristopher had Biliary Atresia. Biliary Atresia has no known cause and affects one in every 10,000 to 20,000 infants soon after birth. This serious form of liver disease is characterized by the destruction of bile ducts, which carry bile from the liver to the small intestine. The bile builds up in the liver and causes progressive damage to the liver tissue. Unless bile flow can be established, liver function is gradually lost, and children rarely survive beyond 2 years. Just before his first birthday, Kristopher underwent the Kaizai procedure, in which doctors made a new drainage system from a piece of his small intestine. The procedure is successful in restoring bile flow for 30 to 50% of patients. For Chris, the procedure saved his life, but his liver had sustained severe and permanent damage due to the late diagnosis of his disease. Immediately after the procedure, he was placed on the transplant waiting list, where his name remains to this day. For the past 13 years, Kristopher has undergone surgery to combat an array of health problems associated with cirrhosis of his liver. At 11 years old, he suffered from severe abdominal bleeding caused by excess fluid in his spleen, and had to undergo procedures every 3 weeks to combat internal bleeding. Presently, things have improved, making only 2 visits at the hospital in the past year and a half. Despite these challenges, Kristopher refuses to let anything slow him down. When he's feeling good, he loves to participate in his 2 favorite things, hockey and running. No one knows what Kristopher's future will hold, says Kelly Knowles, Kristopher's father. All we know is that he has the most incredible will to live. How I met Kristopher Knowles. During my walk across Canada, I entered the city of Sarnia on July 23rd, 2000. It was day 34 of our campaign. We had a wonderful event, great reception, and a very beautiful community. Among the many people we met, there was a young boy that caught my heart. Kristopher Knowles introduced himself to me and explained that he was on the waiting list for a liver transplant. He was 10 years old at the time. After our visit in Sarnia, we continued to make stops in nearly 500 communities. I met thousands of people along the way that had left valuable memories for me. Some of these people have had transplants, and happy stories have followed. Some have been waiting for transplants and have passed away. It sometimes left me emotionally drained that these people could not receive the precious organs that would save their lives. As I was completing my trek across Canada, I was making my way back to my final stop in Toronto. On day 749, July the 8th, 2002, we once again stopped in Sarnia. To my delight, I once again met Kristopher Knowles. He had a great big smile on his face, and he was anxious to carry the torch of life across Sarnia, and who I may add, MPP Caroline DiCoco also participated in the walk. There was every indication to think that Chris had received his liver transplant with his bright mood. Unfortunately, he didn't. Sometimes I can't figure out why some people have to suffer so much in life with afflictions not of their own making. When I think of Kristopher, there's 2 things I feel: inspiration and courage. During our stop in Sarnia, I stayed at the Knowles family residence and got to know a very loving family. After I completed the walk, Chris and his family and myself participated in many more events. I stayed in contact with Chris by email. Chris was sending me letters sharing his thoughts of his wish to walk across Canada. He wanted me to be his road manager and walk for step by step. I was completely overwhelmed by his desire and enthusiasm to attempt a grueling task. I was also touched by this amazing young boy, and at the same time, torn whether I can handle such a responsibility. His family, Dad Kelly, Mom Sandra, Brother Robert, and Sister Ashley, was aware of his dream, and they were 100% behind the idea. Many scenarios were rushing through my head as I was thinking about this. My biggest concern was Chris's safety. After much soul searching, my answer came to me after hearing that he came in second in a 1500 meter race at school. I agreed to be his road manager, thus Kristopher's wish was born. Our road team will include a film crew to document this amazing story, Chris's dad, Kelly Knowles, and assistant road manager, William Adie. Chris will begin his first step in his hometown, Sarnia, January 8, 2004, and ending on December 25, 2004. We are organizing our activities in 200 cities and towns throughout Canada in conjunction with school boards and schools right across the country. In Ontario alone, we are working with 31 school boards, and hundreds of schools, as I'm speaking, are joining in. 76 communities will be greeting Chris and walk with him to local press conferences. I'm also organizing the campaign to make sure that all police forces, hospitals, and airports are aware of Chris's presence each hour of the day and in each and every community as we move along our schedule. Treasured volunteers Joseph Milzarski and Winston Bromley have built a wonderful website to monitor every activity on our entire schedule. They will display an exciting presentation in committee room number 2 following this press conference. Today we have the torch of life with me, which you see behind us. The torch has many miles and many memories behind it. Chris will carry the famous torch in each community and pass it to the youth of our nation. Relentlessly, all of our treasured volunteers and supporters will make sure that Chris has the best care. Kristopher's wish is to help save all the men, women, and children on the waiting list. Is this possible? There are almost 4,000 individuals on this list in Canada. Under Chris's courage, inspiration, and determination, we believe. We know we have to roll up our sleeves and strive as hard as we can. Under Chris's courage, we need to explore every possibility and strive to lead when it comes to organ donations. And want it as bad as the Leafs want to win the Stanley Cup. Good old Canadian spirit. We can do it. 4,000 Canadians is worth it, is it not? I would like to thank MPP Caroline DiCocco and her executive assistant, Matt Garrett, for working very hard organizing this press conference. I would also like to thank Darwin Keeley, who we're proud to say that we're partnering up in this campaign throughout Ontario. Other treasured volunteers include our special events coordinator, Frank Furman, ex-TICAT Angelo Moscow, ex-Argo Bruce Smith, our directors, Mel Davis, Joe Malika, the Karajaganis family, our administrator from BC, Lane Berry, and also our platinum sponsors, Danita and Lenny Lombardi, and all the family from Chin, and all the good folks from Sarnia, Ontario. Remember, almost 4,000 Canadians. Let's all make Kristopher's wish a reality. Thank you.
And now I call on Kristopher, our inspiration, to share his dream.
Hi, my name is Kristopher Knowles. I am 13 years old. I am waiting for a liver transplant. I've been waiting my whole life. My wish is to save 4,000 men, women, and children that are also on the waiting list for organ transplants. A need for organ is great, and the walk that I'm about to take will hopefully inspire everyone to be an organ donor. Thanks. Scars have been with me my whole life. They cover my entire torso. Train tracks passing here and there. Large blue veins branching off into small rivers. I have an unusual belly button that resembles a crater on the moon. People are sometimes frightened when they see my scars, but I don't worry. They don't feel as if they exist. I know that they are there. My scars tell a story about me and my life, and they'll be with me forever. Please support me in my campaign, and remember, don't take your organs to heaven. Heaven knows we need them here. Honor. Thank you for attending our press conference.
So you want to have any questions for Christopher?
It's a big sacrifice. Why do you want to do this?
I want to do this to save 4,000 men and women on the waiting list so they can get organs like me instead of everybody dying and not giving their organs away.
Do you realize the challenge?
Yes.
Could you do it without someone who's gone through this before?
Well, not really, but it's great to get healthy.
Any other questions? Thank you very much for joining us this afternoon.
And I want to say, just before you go, I just saw this photo, I guess, Joseph?
Yes.
It's a beautiful work of art, and I just happened to notice it, and I wanted to make comment on it. And thank Kim Crater for coming down. He's the member from Niagara Falls, so thanks.
You're a part of our member from Sandy Lampson.
Thank you, Speaker. It's a pleasure for me to introduce a young constituent of mine, Kristopher Knowles, and he's here, and he's an inspiration to us all. He is going to do a cross-country walking tour to raise awareness for organ and tissue transplants, and Kristopher is waiting for a liver transplant, and he's here with his family.
Listening to Merle, what I was really looking at was the humility of Kristopher. I first met Kristopher and his father in April of this year. We were all participating in a program at one of the local high schools, and I thought I got there early when I got there at 7:30. But already there was a van in that parking lot. And that van had driven all the way down from Sarnia. I'm afraid to ask them what time they left to be there on time. This is a story when we talk about the gift of life. This is what this story is about. And it's about a family. Again, I went down in the, don't know what month it was, sometime in the spring, to assist George with the promotion of organ and tissue donation at Hamilton Bulldogs hockey game, and who was there but Knowles family. You know, we all do things in life. We all think that what we do makes a difference. None of our efforts compared to the efforts that you have made, not just Kristopher, but as a family. And I think it's very moving to see that sort of commitment. And I know the sacrifice that that you'll make over the next number of months or the next year for this to happen. But you know, Kristopher, there will be a time when you will look back and you will understand why people admire you the way they will admire you. Today it's, I'm not sure that you understand that in the same way. But when you go through those communities and you see the faces, and look at the faces, and it's the faces that will be communicating to you about how much your effort means to a whole bunch of people. And so I would like you to come forward, and perhaps your mom and dad, and just to have an opportunity to share a little bit more about what you'd like to achieve out of it. You know, not the serious part about saying the 4,000 people we know about, okay? But hopefully a little bit about what you're looking forward to in seeing Canada as you travel on this trip. And maybe your parents can join you. Because I'm going to be very honest, you know what we're doing? We're waiting for one very amazing person to join us, the Reverend Bruce Smith, former Toronto Argonaut, who's a great friend of Christopher's. He's going to be here in a couple of moments. So in the meantime, I'm going to ask Christopher's family if they will come forward, because I think more than anything, I just want to see that family standing up here. I don't care if you say a word. I just want you to feel the admiration that we all have for you.
say thanks to everybody and thanks to everybody. I'm not much of a speaker. I'm very shy. I don't like to speak in public. So Christopher here, he's going to be the man. He's going to be up front. I don't want to say it. I'm spitting out there, pal. Hi.
Hello. Thanks, everybody, for coming to help me through my walk. And I'm looking forward to walking. Thanks.
Website that they have put together for Kristopher's Wish.
Thank you, Dory. Good afternoon. My name's Joseph Mokajerski. How I met George is through a colleague. About three and a half months ago, and George was sharing with him about what he's about to do, and I overheard that. I got intrigued. I got addicted. I volunteered my time for anything. It turned out at that moment that I volunteered for the portrait. And with that, I called up a few of my colleagues to see how they could help. They were on board right away. The inspiration that I got from George about this 13-year-old boy, it wasn't about the Kristopher who may die. It wasn't about the Kristopher who needs a liver. It wasn't about the Kristopher who needs help. It was about the Christopher's selflessness, his will, his courage, his determination to make a difference. And that's what inspired me to paint the portrait of him. Kristopher is doing this to bring awareness, step by step, to the organ donation tissues. He may save a life, he may save two, he may save 10, he may save 100, but we put together, we will save a lot more lives if we can do it together. This is about Christopher's courage, his braveness. That is what inspired me to paint this portrait, and design the collateral material, the logos, website. The Kristopher's Wish is very simple. Don't take your organs to heaven, as God knows we can use them here. When George shared with me about his organization step by step, one common theme kept creeping up was that torch. And that torch represents hope, life that we can share. That torch will be passed down today from George to the Kristopher. Like the logo, we had to rebrand the whole logo today. And it was hard to gather, to envelop a dream, a hope, a wish that could save a life in one thing. But that one thing was the torch. So graphically, today, we are passing the torch, not only from George to Christopher, but from step by step to the Christopher's Wish 04. And in that vein, we go now to with the website. And the website is a very generic website, but it can grow. It has room for growth. It is a working website. It works on education levels, works on greeting levels. It works as a catalog. It works as a place in time where the children can come and color and learn about organ donation. We have areas here, for example, the currently walking area, which is right here. This will change every day at 12:01 a.m. This will tell George where he should be the next day. So keep an eye on this. We have about us, the Kristopher's Wish. What is the Kristopher's Wish? We've got his vision, his hopes, his dreams. Then we go by step by step. And in there we have the history of George, Kristopher, the torch. Then we go, contact us. And there we can see addresses, but my favorite part isn't that, it's right here. We can send the Kristopher an email anytime, day or night to cheer him on. We've got media areas where you can see what kind of the press he's got. We've got how to be a donor. We've got online pledging, but the information packages is for the schools. Now, this is the most important part here, where Chris will be. And so this is also for the journalists, and this is also to see where he's been, what he's done, with what he's got, how far he's come. So in time, what we're going to have here are logs of where he's been, what he's done, the pictures. So we're going to have an online journal. And that is pretty well it. Yeah, you can even download the collateral material. It was such as posters, the brochures, the coloring sheets, and time. See, George wanted to focus this to the youth, and we have to educate them early. So we're going to start right from grade one. We're going to design all kinds of youth-related materials. Any questions? I think that's all for me. Thank you.
Well, Joseph and Winston, obviously the passion you have and your commitment to what Kristopher is trying to achieve is not only reflects the quality of all the work you've done, but more importantly, it reflects the being part of your heart. And thank you very much. It's wonderful. I now would like to call on an undertaking of this event has many challenges and many dimensions. So I now like to call on Frank Furman, who is responsible for the special events aspect of it. Frank?
Thank you very much. I guess I'd like to backtrack a bit and let you know how I met George with his inspiring story. A friend of mine, Angelo Mosca, a famous football player and wrestler, asked me to find him a barber. So things started at a barber shop. Of all towns in Port Colborne, Luigi the barber was the only one that knew how to give Mr. Mosca a proper haircut. So this is how it started. Luigi called and said, you and Angela were invited to meet George when George was walking through Port Cobra. And we decided to go out and meet George. And after listening to George's story, about he only had a couple of days left, and you know, it kind of touches a man, I'm here, I'm bigger or small. And I was thinking actually also about my brother. My brother-in-law needs a kidney. So I decided to hook up with George and get started. And we've had the opportunity to meet Kristopher. And Kristopher, I'm telling you, Chris, when I met you, and I mean, your bright smile and your determination. Well, let me put it this way. Tender wishes could not help. Tender wishes said, Frank, we want to do something for Kristopher. And when I asked Kristopher what he wanted, this is going back quite a few months, he said, all I want is for the funds that are raised to be donated to the hospital because we have many of my friends waiting for an organ. And that was like a football hitting me right in the heart. So, Kristopher, you've touched me very deeply, and I'm proud to put in as much time as I can. But just to let some of the people know, Kristopher's got the opportunity to drop a puck at the Hamilton Bulldogs semifinal game with Angela Mosca. We've attended Knights of Columbus and Shrine Sports Celebrity Dinner, where Kristopher awarded Scotty Bowman, a famous coach, with a t-shirt. We've been to, George and the group have been to boxing matches where we met Billy the Kidderman from my area. And up and coming events, we have something happening with the Blue Jays in the near future. And I think you've got to meet a famous band, the Naked Ladies, did you not? Mm-hmm. And you got to meet and greet. And they've offered to do a concert for Kristopher. So we're working on that. And we're trying to combine that with the Blue Jays game. So it'll be an organ and tissue awareness type deal, probably halfway through Kristopher's walk, sometime in the spring. And Kristopher, all I can tell you once again is you've touched me very deeply. And I wish you all the luck in the world, the greatest success. We're going to be with you, behind you, all the way. And we're looking at much more up and coming in 204. And thank you for letting me be a part of it.
Of course, anything as dynamic and as moving as Kristopher's wish deserves to be captured for history, so the people who aren't able to witness it one day can witness it the next. And the person who's going to be responsible for that is our next speaker. And I asked Merle Roberts, who is the producer of the documentary, to come forward and say a few words.
Good afternoon. Hi, Sandra, Kelly, everyone. I first met George back in 1995, I think it was. He was very excited at that time about having received his new liver and, you know, his new opportunity in life, and he was so pumped about making sure that people were aware of the necessity of donor registration and signing that card, and how important it was that people just were aware of being a donor. And we talked about the possibility of doing something back then, and I was actually still in school when learning how to use that camera back there. And I finally met George again, I think it was last year, at a function, and he told me about Kristopher's wish, or about Kristopher, and about step-by-step, and about the walks he'd done across Canada, and the people he'd met, and the message he was spreading. And it just intrigued me that this was such a great story that needed to be captured, needed to be told. And I'm just so glad to be a part of it. And I met Chris and his family. I had dinner. You make a great chili family. And I love everything about this family. So I'm just very pleased to be a part of this project. And I'm sure that great things are going to come out of it, because Chris is just such a wonderful young man. He's got a great character and a great spirit. And that's all I have to say. Thank you very much.
How are you, Chris?
I'm here to see you.
Yeah, that's
over here. You think I gave this a jar? I don't hang out with guys in suits, man.
Yeah.
Are you freaked out by me? What's up? Is he not going to walk with you?
No.
Yeah, I'm just here for a quick event before 7:00. Yeah. What do you need? Yeah, anyway, and I just want to bless him on his trip. And we are people who believe God for miracles, and we know that life itself is a miracle. So I just want to pray and thank God for this, and thank God for George, and thank God for all of you still being here. Anyway, I thank you, Father, that we live in a country like Canada, a country, Lord, where people from every culture and race have come and found refuge, a place where there's religious freedom, place where we can believe something and not be persecuted. I want to thank you for that. Thank you for our new premier and for our new mayor and just a new prime minister and a new challenge ahead for Chris. So Father, I want to thank you for Chris. I want to thank you for George and give him the passion to do what only he could do with your help. And Lord, today we come on behalf of Chris. And Lord, as you are God of heaven, as you made us, today we ask you to bless Chris. We ask you to bless and protect him on this journey. We ask you to strengthen him and make his way safe. We ask you to give him a new heart. We ask that. We ask that you would remember all the people who are waiting for organs, and that you would bless them too. And Lord, as a Christian, I pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. 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 Does he stand back in
the basketball game? He's playing
ball. Pumping iron?
Yeah. Chicken legs, chicken arms.
Chicken, he wouldn't want to fall for us to get along like this. Start playing with that, playing that day.
Okay, did you want to sing a song?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hi, Josh.
Hi.
Hello, Joshua from England. Singing artists, and I just want to sing a song for Chris. Sometimes in life we have brokenness and broken pieces, and we have to do things that sometimes is really broken to the heart. But I dedicate a song to you. Even on broken pieces, I will make it to show. A storm cloud may rise, and you'll be alone. Put your faith in God, and you can make it to shore. 'Cause even on your broken pieces, you can make it to shore. He that feedeth the sparrow, you will take care of you. Your prayer may seem long, but it will show. And he that feedeth the sparrow, he will take care of you. 'Cause even on your broken pieces, you can make it to shore. God bless you.
At this point, what I would like to do is to have George and Kristopher come forward for the passing of the torch of light. This is the torch that George carried while he toured throughout Canada to promote organ and tissue awareness. And today he will be handing that torch over to Chris, and Chris will be carrying this torch into high schools and communities across Canada during the next year or so, George.
Thank you, Dr. It's my pleasure to pass you the torch of life, which has a lot of memories behind it, including one time when our motorhome, we were near Woodstock, Ontario, and our motorhome accidentally ran over the bottom piece, so we lost half the torch. And we were walking around with a sawed-off torch for a while. And amazingly enough, during our stop in Colborne, there was an industrial arts teacher that was walking with us, and he looked at the torch and said, "You know what? I can fix that." And at that moment that he said that, on the highway, the very moment that he said that, there was this bottom piece right in front of him. And it was just an amazing thing, because he picked it up, and it fit perfect, you know, so. And then there was the part with the lady from Sarnia, who had maybe a couple of weeks left to live, and who was very, very sick, and her husband was against the idea of her carrying the torch to pass it to the mayor that day, but she came out and being very sick, she carried the torch and passed it to the mayor. And 3 weeks later, I got a call from her saying that she had received a liver transplant. And the moment that she got out of the hospital, she started phoning all her family across Canada, and she has a lot of family across Canada. And she organized all my stops with each family member in different communities from coast to coast. They were already there to carry the torch, you know. And it goes on and on. He was also blessed by His Holiness Pope John Paul II. As I was making my way to BC, I got a call from Vatican City, and first I thought it was Billy joking around. And it was someone from Vatican City, and they said, we're arranging an audience with you and His Holiness on September 5th, 2001. And on that day, we passed the torch to the Pope, and he blessed it. So there's a lot of stories. So we're passing it on to you, and it's going to be your show for the next year. Mm-hmm.
I now would like to call on George Marcello, the founder of Step by Step, to proceed with a special activity.
Thank you, Doc. At this occasion, I want to just take the opportunity to say thank you to all our treasured volunteers and supporters throughout the 5 years and right up to this moment in helping to construct Kristopher's Wish. It does take a lot of hard work in trying to accomplish something of this magnitude. And I can tell you, when you're coming on to this campaign, what I tell people is, better put on your seatbelt, because you're going in for a ride, because there's a lot of ups and downs, and it gets extremely emotional at times. So, but I'm here right now to recognize our platinum sponsors, which is Chin, and Danina Lombardi in particular. I met Danina Lombardi, who, by the way, is the daughter of the late great Johnny Lombardi. I met Danina, I think it was early 1999, shortly after I finished my Toronto-Ottawa walk and was preparing for the Ontario walk. And at that point in time, you know, we weren't really known to the media, or we were just kind of setting out, it was like a wish, a dream that somebody has one day and decides to do something, but knows that to accomplish it, it's going to take so much work. And I mean, that's the stage that I was at. And somehow, Danina invited me to share my dream with her. And I remember being in her office, and she was letting me speak and letting me share everything, you know, that I had inside me. And it was at that point that Danina agreed to help me out. And she did so by arranging many television appearances and contacts. And I really found Danina to be so genuine, too. I thought I was meeting this big star, and you know, she wouldn't have any time for somebody like me. And I'll tell you, she's one of the most grounded persons that I met. And throughout the past 4 years, Danina and all the Chen family, Ali Bidabadi's here too, who's been great in helping with so many activities. We've organized things at the famous Chen picnic at Canada Wonderland. It just goes on and on. Presently, Danina is putting out a commercial of Chris in 30 different languages. And on a daily basis, there's plans to continue the coverage as Chris goes on his campaign. So there's so much that we're in gratitude to Danina and the Chen family. And as a token of our appreciation, we really didn't have that much time. And when I was saying that so many things happen when you're trying to prepare something and you don't always get it, we got another surprise that we want to give you at a later date, Danina. But right now, we got a surprise that we want to offer you. And if you can come up here to take a look.
There's been no time.
So Kristopher and I have a cake. I just want to say thank you very much for this beautiful cake, and I'm looking forward to my next surprise. I'm a kid at heart. I met George a few years ago and found that I was a grounded person. It's people like George who keeps me grounded, and it's why I'm continuing my father's initiatives in broadcasting. We broadcast in over 30 languages at Chin, and I know that the message of organ and tissue donation is not a message that people want to talk about and hear about. It's a message of our mortality, and it's a very difficult thing for most of us to deal with, and rather unpopular. And George was relentless in his belief. He was delivered a miracle through the kindness of a family. He was given a liver and a chance of life, and I truly believed in his message, and I had to sort of screw up my nerve, George, because it was a very unpopular message, and deliver it, sort of sell it to our producers in our communities. We've been doing that for 4 years, and you know, I can be up here and we can be here speaking about it, something that I couldn't do 4 years ago. I met Kristopher 2 years ago at a press conference when George returned to Toronto. I had not met him yet, but I saw him in the crowd and I thought, that child has the face of an angel, an absolute cherub. And then I met him. And I've watched him grow over the last 2 years. He's a wonderful child, the most wonderful family, and he's quite a poet, he's very talented, and I truly believe that he's going to be very successful. And Kristopher, you've already made such an impact on the people you've met. I hope you know that. And thank you very much. And I hope everyone enjoys a piece of the cake later.
Thank you. Thank everyone for coming out and supporting Kristopher this afternoon. And I think we're all going to head home thinking about things a little differently. And I think we have Kristopher Knowles to thank for that. Good luck. We'll follow your journey closely, and hopefully we'll see you along the way in the community. So thank you, everyone.
George, with a new diagnosis of the disease, has been given to the doctor of the cancer. contacted news that liver was available, and here I am today, thanks to the donor family.
And since then, you've dedicated your life to promoting organ and tissue awareness, donation awareness. And Kristopher, what year, maybe George, you can tell us, in what year did you meet Kristopher?
Actually, when I was doing my Canada tour in 2000, July 23rd, right. 2000, I was passing through Sarnia, and I seen a young boy eager to carry the torch of life that you see in front of me right here.
Yes.
And he carried it across Sarnia like a champ, and it was at the end that he told me that he was on the waiting list also for a liver transplant, and it was just amazing. Seeing this young boy who had this big smile on his face, and since then, like, you're going to hear what we're going to announce today.
Kristopher, how old are you?
13.
You're at that age where you're sort of hiding your smile. And you were diagnosed with liver disease when you were an infant, so you've been waiting all your life for a liver, right?
Yes.
And you're from Sarnia, Ontario, so hi everybody in Sarnia. You have much reason to be very proud of one of your own. Kristopher, when will you start your walk?
January 8, 2004 in Sarnia, and I'll finish December 25th in Toronto.
Congratulations. So your dream, your wish is...
to walk across Canada.
Is to walk across Canada, and you'll be starting in just a matter of a couple of weeks.
Yep.
That's wonderful. George, you have something planned for this week at Queen's Park.
Yes, we have a very exciting event this Thursday, December 18th at Queen's Park, between 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock. We're going to have Master of Ceremonies Ted Wallachin introduce some very special guests. Included will be the Health Minister, the Honorable Minister of Health, George Smitherman. Chris is going to have a meet and greet with the Premier. We also have a host of other MPPs and MPs that will be attending. And another thing that we're proud to announce on that day is that we're going to pay a special tribute to Chin.
Thank you, George. We've been sort of supporting you from the outset when I remember it was very difficult for me a few years ago to even talk about organ and tissue awareness and donation. You gave me a lot of literature. I remember how fascinating the literature was with regard to different world religions and how it is very accepted. And, of course, you paid a visit to the Pope in the Vatican. You were received by Pope John Paul II. And he told you what?
Well, on that day, on September 5th, 2001, after His Holiness blessed this torch, he proclaimed on behalf of Vatican City that organ and tissue donation is a genuine act of love, and urged the whole world to become organ donors. And that was a very historic announcement, and we're very grateful that His Holiness did do that.
Well, that's wonderful. You're making a history, George and Kristopher, and you have a poem.
Yes.
Where is your poem? This is written by you, Kristopher?
Yeah, I'm grade 6. Scars have been with me my whole life. They uncover my entire torso. Train tracks passing here and there. Large blue veins branching off into small rivers. I have an unusual belly button that resembles a crater on the moon. People are sometimes frightened when they see my scars, but I don't worry. I just don't feel as if they exist. My scars, I know that they are just there. My scars tell a story about me and my life, and they'll be with me forever.
That's beautiful, Kristopher. And you wrote that in grade 6?
Yeah.
Okay. You promised you wouldn't make me cry. You're just such a wonderful kid. We wish you the best. And just remind us how people can support your walk across Canada, just to let people know that organ and tissue donation is something they should be talking about in their families, and it certainly does save lives. So how can people support you?
Well, we're hoping people can visit our brand new and exciting website. It's www.kristophers.wish.ca. In that site, we're going to be showing every stop in Canada. We have almost 200 cities that we're going to be visiting, and people can see the full agendas on that day in that community. And we're hoping a lot of people will come and visit that site and they can get any other information in supporting us that way.
Well, congratulations, George. Congratulations, Kristopher. We'll be hearing from you. You'll be calling in to our radio programs, the Italian Morning Show, as you progress across Canada. And I've just put my green ribbon on. This is a green, I'm wearing a green ribbon in support of organ and tissue donation. I want to thank you both very much. Wish you all the best. And see you Wednesday at Queen's Park.
Yeah, and Chris has a final thing to say.
Go ahead, Chris.
Oh, come back. Come back.
Buono Natale. Thank you.
Tivoglio.
And Tivoglio bene assai assai. Kristopher, God bless you. Thank you, sweetie. And now I'm throwing to Vittorio Coco and his guest.
Hi, my name is Kristopher Knowles. I am 13 years old. I am waiting for a liver transplant. I've been waiting my whole life.
Only a new liver can save young Kristopher's life, and he's on top of the list. Unfortunately, there just aren't enough organs to go around. But Kristopher is determined to change that, embarking on a cross-country journey to raise awareness.
I'm doing this to save 4,000 Canadians, 4,000 men, women, and children that are on the waiting list for organ transplants, to tell everybody to sign their organ donor cards so people like me and the 4,000 Canadians can live.
Kristopher will begin his journey here, in his hometown of Sarnia, on January 8th. Then, he'll make his way westward, over here, to Victoria, British Columbia. He'll start the eastern leg of his tour in St. John's, Newfoundland, and make his way to Toronto, and be here on December 25th, next year. But it won't be easy. Although he looks like an ordinary kid, Kristopher is in fragile health. He's had 20 operations in his short life, and has the scars to prove it.
I'm not worried, but I'm hoping that halfway through I'm going to get my liver. And then my brother, Robert, he's going to finish the journey because they're not just going to stop it.
Why are you doing this?
Because he's my brother and I want to take part in this and help out any way I can.
Chris won't be alone on the track. His father will walk right alongside him.
We're going to finish this walk. We're determined to make a difference in organ and tissue donation. And I know Christopher can do it.
It's going to be hard. Are you worried about it?
No, he's with Dad, and I know the spirit, and he can do this.
Most kids your age right now are thinking about what they're going to get for Christmas.
Yeah.
You're a pretty special kid.